Hiya! Welcome! So we're now 2 days removed from the biggest wrestling event, certainly in the United Kingdom. 81,065 people, I think, were announced as the legit attendance at Wembley Stadium for All Elite Wrestling's first foreign pay-per-view, all in London. I was one of those 81,000, as was my friend Dan, who I made the trip with from here in the East Midlands down to London and Wembley Stadium. So this is just a video telling you about my experiences, interspersed with a few clips here and there. So I went down on the Saturday, which was the 26th, and got from Chesterfield to Golders Green at about 4:30 in the afternoon.
Well, day one of going to Wembley, which is tomorrow, the Sunday. I've got here in London on Saturday, currently at Golders Green coach station, and found my favourite place, the box.
Nice.
Just waiting for my friend Dan, minding his suitcase for him. I've not got a suitcase, I've just got a bag. Here he comes now.
After going for a coffee, we got an Uber to our hotel, which was in Brentford, a Premier Inn. I'll put a picture up. That isn't a picture I've took, by the way. That's one I just nicked off the Premier Inn's website. Decent hotel, Premier Inn, you know what you're getting with them, really, don't you? The one downside was my room was just pungent with tobacco smoke, and I get the feeling it'd been like that for a little while, but because they're having guests come in every time someone checks out, someone will check in again, they've just not had a chance to air the room out properly. Regardless, it didn't bother me that much. I did make kind of a complaint to the staff, but I said I don't want to change rooms or anything, because my room was next door to Dan's anyway, so it was convenient like that.
So it's just gone 6 o'clock on the Saturday evening, and, oops, I don't keep the bed. I'm in the hotel room, which is in Brentford, nowhere near Wembley, but hey, it's a hotel in London, it'll do. So it's my home for the next 2 nights. It's Premier Inn. Yeah, you've all seen what a hotel room looks like, I'm sure. It's quite a nice sort of sofa bed there. I'm sat on the proper bed, by the way. There we are. So yeah, I think I'm gonna make myself a cup of tea. And I know we've got dinner booked here about 7:30, and of course breakfast in the morning.
So we had dinner at the hotel, which was really nice. Lovely 2 courses and a drink all included together, just for an extra price on top of your room rate. After dinner, Dan had got his tablet set up, so we watched the previous night's WWE SmackDown, which was a tribute to the late Terry Funk and Bray Wyatt, among other things happening on the show. We watched that in his room, and then had a relatively early night. Not that early, I never go to bed particularly early, even when I know I've got a long, long day the next day. But had a good night's sleep. Woke up on the Sunday morning, had a big breakfast so that I was nice and full and I wouldn't want to eat anything again until the evening, by which time we would be watching the show. So we finished breakfast, got an Uber from Premier Inn in Brentford to Wembley Stadium. Doesn't take too long, around 25-30 minutes ish, so not too bad at all really. Found the zone, we were in Wembley. I've never been to the new Wembley, by the way, but I went to the old one many years ago. That was for a football playoff final, and there wasn't half as many people there as there was for AEW All In on the Sunday.
So I arrived at Wembley. This is the section that we'll be entering in about just over an hour. Dan's in the queue for merchandise, which is a big queue, but apparently it's actually one of the shortest queues around the whole stadium, according to somebody. And I'm just going to get a nice cup of coffee and a drink for Dan. So probably the next time you'll see us, we may well be in the stadium, unless I see anything else interesting to film on the outside here. But yeah, as you can see, ton of people. Nice vibe so far. Everyone's just coming, he's looking forward to a historic wrestling event, so stay tuned.
such a massive place. I mean, it's kind of overwhelming, but nice vibe, you know, full of wrestling fans, just really excited for an historic event. We had a couple of hours to kill or so before we could start queuing to get in. That's something that takes forever. Dan got some merchandise. I just kind of sat around having a coke. I managed to see Glenn, Geeky Heathen, who is a channel supporter and patron of mine, and is a YouTube content creator himself. So it was nice to meet him. I wasn't able to get a photo with him, sadly, but I'll flash his YouTube handle up on screen. Also attending was this certain guy here, who I'm pointing to. Of course, I have already met Jason a couple of times. He's been to my home, and I also went with him to Comic Con Yorkshire. I didn't get to see him at Wembley, but not to worry. It was more on the off chance that I even managed to meet Glenn. So they were letting in at 3:30. Of course, we were queuing a little bit before 3:30, and it probably took well over an hour, or just over an hour, I'd say, before we're able to get into the stadium and find our seats. Nice and straightforward as far as security is concerned. You know, I had the tickets on my wallet app on my phone, and it was easy just to shove that under the scanner and go through the turnstiles. It's just the standing around and waiting that's the difficult bit, you know, and it's tiring, and there's a lot of walking as well when you're kind of walking around the perimeters and you're just looking for somewhere to sit or somewhere to get a drink, or if you're queuing up to buy something. I didn't buy any merchandise, by the way. Dan did. He got himself a scarf, a baseball cap, which you'll have seen in the thumbnail, and a couple of lanyards, and he gave an all-in lanyard to me. I haven't got it to hand to show you at the moment, but thank you again, Dan, for that. I appreciate it, mate. Got to our seats around, I would say, probably 4:45, so, you know, just about 20 minutes before the pre-show was starting, the zero-hour show, free portion of the event, as AEW would call it.
So it's 4:30 in the afternoon, we've got to our seats, and we're waiting for Zero Hour to start. And of course, this is Dan.
Oh, yeah.
I did mention that I was travelling down and watching All In with him. Took us a while to get in, but, you know, there's 80-odd thousand people trying to get in. So I'll just pan around the stadium and give you what our view from our seats in a moment.
The seats, I'd paid for the level one, so that was the level above all the floor seating. They were all right. It will affected me and many others, but just because we were at an angle, like, as I'm pointing, the ring was, like, way over there. There was scaffolding in the way, but, you know, we could see four screens, two of them in particular, pretty easy to look at. And even though the floor seating, you look across and you think, well, that will be more expensive. I think most of the floor seating would have had a particularly good view. I think if you were at ringside or on the first level, but real kind of symmetrical, or if that's the right term, with the ring and the entrance set up and everything, then that's probably like your best seats. But I just wanted to go for the experience. I didn't want to sit in the nosebleed section, because then, you know, everything's like ants. You've just like had a long day for something that would have looked much better on TV. And the atmosphere in our section was fantastic, I have to say. Wembley itself, as I say, first time I've been in the new Wembley Stadium, which people consider a different stadium to the old one, but it's semantics, really. it's weird, even though the roof was open throughout the night because of the fireworks, and also it was a lovely day, it did rain very briefly, probably around 2:30, 3:30, and then it stopped in like less than 5 minutes, and it was only a minor shower anyway. But throughout the day, lovely weather, really cloudy, but you know, mild, sunny, a half decent British summer day really. So as for the show itself, as I say, the pre-show 0 hour, 5 o'clock that kicked off, and then 6 o'clock was the pay-per-view start time, so we were there in time for everything. I won't go on too much about my opinions of the show, because there'll be plenty of other people who've given their opinions. There is of course some footage that I've taken that I'll insert in a moment into this video. I didn't want to take an awful lot of footage because this is a televised event, and you can see highlights elsewhere or order the pay-per-view if you want to do so and watch it properly. But I just wanted to take a few shots as my sort of perspective from where Dan and I were sitting in the stadium.
explained that Badass Billy Gunn have chosen the stipulation to be no holds
So it was a great night. Getting out of Wembley was probably the worst part of the whole weekend, to be honest, because it just took so long. The walk just from the stadium into a part of Wembley where the roads weren't closed and you could actually call for an Uber or get a bus or a taxi or whatever you might be doing took long enough. We were worried because we'd had a couple of Uber requests cancelled. And then finally, this would have been, the show ended at around 10 o'clock. This was well over an hour after that, and we were sat in like this little Brazilian bar restaurant place in Wembley Town. Finally, our third Uber request did get accepted. So we were back at the hotel in Brentford before midnight, which I don't think was too bad really, considering I had visions of us sat in this bar killing time for hours and then not getting back to the hotel until the wee small hours. The most stressful part of the day, but it all came good in the end, as I thought it would. Wonderful stuff. So the following day was when we went home, really. Got up a bit earlier. Nice big breakfast again. Uber from Premier Inn Brentford to Golders Green bus station. Little bit of time to kill as we made sure we were there quite early, just so that we weren't having to rush around. So went for a coffee, had a little walk around, went to the local shop to buy some water and paracetamol for my headache. Fascinating, isn't it? Our coach came at about 12:40. 3 hour or so trip back home. Not so bad. I was back at home late afternoon, as I hoped and expected I would be. So that was my AEW all-in weekend experience. As I say, I'm not going to go on about my favourite matches and stuff. The highlights I've shown in the video were just random moments when I decided to start filming, but I do urge you to go and look at better clips and other clips and even the whole pay-per-view itself if you want to see just a real kind of historic wrestling show with a great atmosphere. They're doing it again next year, AEW. They're coming back to Wembley around the same time next August. It kind of takes away a little bit, I feel, from the specialness of this event, but I can say that I was at the first one, the very first All In London, which broke worldwide records regarding attendance. And I think for a company like AEW, which is still a relatively young wrestling company, to be able to do that at the UK's biggest and most famous stadium is a massive achievement. So well done to everyone at All Elite Wrestling. Hope all of the 81,065, I'm worried I'm getting that figure slightly wrong, it's definitely over 81,000. Had a great time at Wembley, like Dan and I did. Thank you for watching this video. I've probably forgotten a few details. If I remember anything, I would have flashed it up on screen somewhere. but I want to say special thanks to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. You already know the drill regarding links for stuff in the description text box, so I won't bang on about that now. I will just say my goodbyes and ask that you will join me again next time, and I don't know when that'll be, for some sort of wrestling vlog related video. I don't know. Cheers, everyone. See ya!